The Potomac Appalachian Trail Club utilizes a group of volunteers known as the GPS Rangers to survey hiking trails, locate problems, and provide trail crews with accurate details of the what, where, and how big of a problem exists so the necessary skills can be brought to bear. Typically, a survey will begin with one or more rangers examining a map and guidebook at their house to plan out the route and prepare for a day afield. At their car, they make a final review of the planned route and discuss all safety issues of the day. They then clear the GPS track of their device so they can collect an accurate and complete route for that survey. En route, they automatically collect a GPS track point every 3 seconds. The GPS rangers collect accurate GPS coordinates called waypoints for all photos of trail features, such as parking areas, trailheads, signage, etc. When an obstruction such as a blowdown is encountered, they will take its GPS waypoint, then measure its diameter, and take a set of photos. The goal is to assist trail maintainers in sizing up the work to be done and giving them a precise location and good view of each blowdown so the right size crew with the necessary tools can be assembled. Back at their house, the report is written up and additional maps, if necessary, are produced and forwarded to the appropriate district managers. At this point, the rangers hand off responsibility to the trail maintainers who will clear the obstruction. Arriving at the trailhead, the sawyers assemble their gear and decide what other tools will be necessary to remove the blowdown. Having gotten a detailed description and photos of the tree, the crew decides to bring a Maasdam rope puller, blocks, and slings to stabilize a large root ball or remove it from the trail. Sawyers will bring along a crosscut saw instead of a chainsaw for ease of carry on the long hike in. The hike is an 8-mile round trip from the trailhead with an elevation gain of almost 2,000 feet. Once at the blowdown, we size it up and determine a cut plan with an eye to an unstable and potentially dangerous root ball uphill of the trail. The tree is forked at the base with the larger stem in contact with the ground. We will remove the smaller stem first. The saw cuts quickly and soon the upper stem is removed. Before beginning our second cut, we stabilize the root ball with a rope puller, utilizing a block to double our mechanical advantage. As we proceed with our second cut, wedges are driven behind the saw to hold the kerf open, and a skid is placed under the trunk to help with its later removal. The hard, dry, and partially frozen oak is under extreme top bind, and an aluminum wedge is used between the plastic wedges to help force the kerf open. The finish cut is made, and the wedges are driven deeper to spread the kerf. The downslope weight of the root ball creates an end-bind condition that could interfere with its removal. However, by inserting several cut hickory branches into the wedge-widened kerf, we create a rolling pin effect that lets us pull the whole root ball to the side with the rope puller, with an assist from the skid we placed under the log earlier. We also incorporate additional blocks for mechanical advantage and to lower the stress on any one component. Next, we re-rig the rope puller high on the root ball and again use mechanical advantage to pull it out of its hole and stopping to remove the sling as it approaches a tipping point. Using a long pole for leverage, a trail maintainer prepares to pitch the root ball off the trail. Coming to rest downslope and well off the trail's bench, the root ball is no longer an obstruction. With the trail now clear and our gear packed up, we return to the trailhead and the ride home.